Good morning, and thank you for tuning in to the Live 5 show where we are living live. I'm Jimmy Tseng.
And I'm Alexis Nokos. We have a quick play for you about the TriStar basketball.
And it's time to show off your moves in this year's Test Off Dance Off. Stay tuned for more.
Will there be another heat wave next week?
And who won the NCAA championship title yesterday?
All of this and much more.
Before it goes away.
You know, yours? And where we stop, no.
Hello, villagers of Tetzloff. Cell phones on campus. You cannot have cell phones on. You cannot have video games on campus. If you do, then you wind up like Justin Bieber here and in jail. Thank you very much. Have a nice day. Drive safe. Be careful.
Welcome back, and now for the news.
Children from across the field compete in the TriStar basketball contest. They were tested on shooting baskets, dribbling against time, and accurate passes. Here's a quick play from Clarissa Weezer. Oh my gosh.
Hey children, I'm Clarissa Weezer and I'm at TriStar basketball contest at lunch. Let's take a look. What is TriStar basketball?
TriStar basketball is a skills competition sponsored by the Junior Optimist Club here at Tetzloff for anyone who wants to take part.
This is a scoring sheet. It scores your dribbling pass, your dribbling, your passing, and your shooting.
What do you have to do?
Well, right now at this station, you have to try to hit the basketball at the gray spot.
What you have to do?
Yes, you need to have shooting, dribbling, and passing. Those are the three tests.
Hope you guys had fun. I'm Carissa Weezer reporting from the Live 5 show.
Thank you, Carissa. If you're wondering, you can find the TriStar results on Miss Burke's window. It's here again, the third annual Tetzloff Dance Off. If you're interested in showing off your moves, then you sign up with a Color Guard member today. The Dance Off will be held this Thursday, April 7th, from 6 to 7 p.m. in the auditorium.
Carissa Weezer. There you go. This week, except tomorrow, there will be an international society meeting at lunch. This will give you time to work on your spring crafts, international society members.
Today is a chance for you children to receive your Tdap booster vaccination. You will be able to get it at Artesia High from 3 to 6 p.m. You must receive it before September 2011. Your parent or legal guardian needs to tag along with your immunization records. Remember, there is no fee for families without medical insurance.
A Houston traffic sign takes a detour of its own when a past person changed the portrayed message. Then an anonymous suspect changed the traffic sign from its original message to poop. That's messed up. The sign stayed the way it was until the suspect changed the sign again from poop to a smiley face and LOL. Everybody knows what that stands for. On a Monday morning. Raquel Lewis of the Texas Department of Transportation wasn't entertained. He thought of this as a serious matter. The anonymous joker could suffer a $500 fine if caught. This prank mirrored an accident back in 2009 when a traffic sign in Austin, Texas, and zombies in the area run.
That's pretty neat.
I know. Who would
think the iPad was cool? Wait till you see the iPad 2 released to Apple consumers. This new iPad is 15% lighter and 33% thinner, making it easier to carry around. The instant on the feature makes the iPad 2 turn on and run faster than the original iPad. The two high-definition cameras allow you to FaceTime with your friends and family in a great picture quality. The iPad 2 has a free application called Find My iPad that tells you where your iPad 2 is when you misplace it at a party or any other place. The 10-hour battery life allows gamers to enjoy the iPad 2, whether it's on a road trip or relaxing at home. iPad 2 has storage memory of 16 or 32 gigabytes to store apps, build a music library, or for academic purposes. Prices start at $499. It's expensive.
Now it's time for your daily dispatch where Gwendolyn Lau is reading today, Epic Fail.
Hey children, this week's Epic Fail is all about bike fails. Let's check it out. Well, did you like that video? I did. And did you see that kid with the speed bike? Well, I'll see you next week for more epic fails.
You know,
yeah, that.
Those were girls that really wouldn't hurt. Taking a look at Tetzloff's calendar, this week is the ice cream sales after school, and there will be an international society meeting at lunch. Today is the science club, and Artesia High is holding a Tdap vaccination. Tomorrow is Trojan Pride Day. Don't forget to wear blue. Thursday is the third annual Tetzloff dance off, and Friday is a minimum day, college day, and Italian ice sales after school. And that wraps up the ongoing events. Now let's go to Victoria Lee with the weather. Good morning, Victoria.
Good morning, Alexis. It will be raining on Friday and Saturday, and today will be in the 70s, so it'll be pretty warm. It's also going to be sunny today also. Let's take a look at the map. Windy and rainy in the East Coast, while it's going to be sunny in the West. And it will be raining up in around Seattle also. Let's take a look at the Friday forecast. It's going to be partly cloudy today, continue on to Thursday, while Friday, Saturday will be rainy. Temperature will be 71, dropping until Friday and rising up in Saturday. Let's bring it over to Andres with a wet pole.
We have Melissa with us, she's the editor for the script. So, what do you think about the new web poll? Well, would you like to read the web poll first?
Sure. Do you think the tidy sweep system is a good idea?
Here's what you guys said. Yes, it scares me. It scares me to be late now. No, I have nine tardies anyway. It's weird. Anyway, so send your thoughts and opinions to webpoll at liveandfiveshow.com, and we want to hear from you. Especially that guy who got nine tardies. How do you get that many tardies? Anyway, so what do you think about the tardy sweep?
I don't like it because, like, I just broke my foot, so now I'm going to be, like, late to every single class for a while, so.
Okay. Good luck on that foot.
Thank you.
All right, so that's all I have for today. Goodbye.
Thank you, Andres. It's now time to swing into action with your Live and 5 Sports Report with Erin. Good morning, Erin. How you doing?
And everything in between, this is your Live and 5 Sports. I'm Erin. Kimba Walker finished with 16 points for UConn, who won their 11th straight game since closing the regular season. The Huskies were able to beat the Butler Bulldogs 53-41 to win the NCAA championship title. Butler did horrible, shooting 18.8%, the worst ever in a title game. Congrats to the Huskies, though, who have won their third national title. And although there were no NBA games yesterday, today the Clippers will be taking on the Memphis Grizzlies and the Lakers will be playing against the Utah Jazz. In baseball, the Dodgers will play against the Rockies and the Angels will play against the Rays. So many games, I wonder who's going to win. Well, that's it for today, folks. Shout out to Raul. Okay, back to you, Jimmy. I don't know.
Shout out to Juan and the track team. Go join track if you're fast. Okay. Thank you, Erin. It's time to touch on all city 411.
When was the first nationally televised April Fool's prank? 1924, 1936, 1948, or 1957? Take 5.
Everything is about April Fool's. I made something like interesting.
36.
Like, when was
how long ago?
Born, you know?
Like Dragon Ball. Like 1857.
Hey,
you know what I had for breakfast? I had butter coconut toast from Guppy.
You know, that is really random. We were talking about April Fools, and now you're talking about what you ate for breakfast.
What'd you eat for breakfast?
I ate cereal.
I never have breakfast. Pops.
It's not good.
Well, that's why you're not healthy. Pops. Well, I'm just kidding, but you need to eat breakfast. It's one healthy meal you need to eat. I sound like geek. Okay. Visit our website to watch today's broadcast online at livefightshow.com and follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube.
That's the end of today's show. We'll see you back here tomorrow morning.
You sound like my mom.